हाय दोस्तों, वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक। आप सभी को हमारे यूट्यूब चैनल में स्वागत है। दिस वीडियो इज रिगार्डिंग अ कोविड 19 डेथ एक्स ग्रेटिया 50,000 रुपीज पेमेंट फॉर महाराष्ट्र। वंस यू आर अप्लाइंग ऑनलाइन, यू आर फेसिंग सम प्रॉब्लम्स लाइक दिस। यू आर नॉट एबल टू एडिट द हाफ सेव्ड एप्लीकेशन, यू आर नॉट एबल टू डिलीट द एप्लीकेशन। सो हाउ टू रिकवर फ्रॉम दिस प्रॉब्लम, एज यू कैन सी हियर सम ऑफ द कमेंट्स आई रिसीव्ड इन माई वीडियो, दोस्त people are facing some problem, so this video will help them to come out of this. Okay, so before that I'm going to show you the screenshot of how you are going to apply. If you have not yet applied, please watch my previous video, the link is coming on top. You can click there and see how to apply for 50,000 rupees ex gratia in Maharashtra, anywhere in Maharashtra. Okay, so once you apply, this is the screenshot I'm just showing you, highlight. You have to enter mobile, then you get an OTP like this. You enter the OTP. First you have to fill applicant details, like who is giving the application, those details, then a deceased detail, that means the person who died, his details. This is the second page, and third page is like again deceased details, like his date of birth, gender and stuff. Some people are saying they are not getting the third sheet on the application online. Then don't worry about that. Whatever page you are getting, just fill it in. Do not worry about some pages are missing or not. And fourth page is very important, your bank details, like where you are going to get the 50,000 rupees and stuff, IFSC code and all those things. Okay, this is the procedure. So once your procedure or application is success, you get something like this application ID. Okay, cov something will come, and you can also check the status your application. I have shown in the previous video how to check the application status, and once you apply, immediately it will show you it's as pending. So this is the normal process. When everything is success, your application will go through like this, you get an application ID. But some of the friends are facing like this. I have taken the snapshot or screenshot of my video messages from my close friends. Sir, my filling information is wrong, so how to edit information, please help. That means he has filled and in between something went wrong, say connection is wrong, log out. He wanted to change because there is no edit option given in this website as of now. Then same problem, this friend is also facing same problem. Signed out in between, maybe you lost connection, whatever happens, you are switched off mobile. Later come back and when try to fill a new form, right? Site is showing already exist. That means you lost a connection and you come back and applying, it is saying it is already exist. So, but this person has not yet filled the bank details. So last page was skipped for him. So this is a painful thing. You can't edit also, and you were not able to delete also that time. So this is same thing, application exist shokarai. So how to resolve these issues? I'm showing you the easiest method as of now existing in the website to correct or refile the application. Friends, this is the method. You are going to the mahacovid19relief.in. I am giving this link in my video description. I will show you how to do when your application is not fully success. Just enter the mobile number. This is a normal process. I am not going to take you through all the process. It will be very quick. You entered your mobile number, you entered your OTP, and you click on submit. This is the normal process. When you start applying, anyone has to go through this process only. So I click on submit button. First time, obviously it logs in and show you to fill the applicant details. Okay, here you are going to, this is a normal process. So applicant details should be perfectly given. You have to attach your Aadhaar card copy here, and your Aadhaar card number, first name, second name, all these things. You cannot change it later. Okay, so make sure applicant details are properly given, perfectly given. The name, first name, last name has to be chosen as per Aadhaar card name. Okay friends, short name also possible. Okay, so according to your Aadhaar, you can even give second name as short name also. Your gender, date of birth, and your complete address, save and continue. This is the first page. Now next page, you are going to get the deceased details, the person who died, his details has to be furnished here. I'm going to give you have to fill one by one deceased details, that person who died, his details has to be given. I have already filled it in, I'm not going to waste your time. I have already filled it in, all the details of the deceased person. And finally you have to click on agree and continue and proceed. This is the normal process, and it will come to the bank details addition page, right? So now you are going to add the bank details. Some people not getting third page. fourth page directly to bank. So I am going to simulate same thing. So now say in between it was logged out. I am going to simulate the logout. I go to the application link right side on top and click on logout buttons. You can see here I have logged out. So what happens? This can happen logout or you lost your connection, whatever, you restarted to mobile. I am logging in again. So let us see what happens. Okay, as you can see here, OTP has sent successfully. I enter the OTP, click on submit button, and I go inside the portal. Okay, sorry, OTP was wrong. I enter the correct OTP. Once you go inside the portal, so what happens? Let us see. Directly it will go to deceased details again. Okay, and you have to fill the deceased details again. So I didn't lose anything, but say I wanted to remove this application and file fresh application. What you had to do? So again, click on the right side on top three line icon. After that, click on application status. Okay, once you click on application status, it will take you to the page where you can see here half filled application is there. So that is why it may be not allowing to again file one more application. I don't want this application. So there is a delete button. Just now they have introduced, previously it was not there. Just click on delete. So once you click on delete, you get an error like this. As of now, they will fix it, but don't worry about this error. Just press a back button on your browser or mobile. Press a back button, go back to previous page and just refresh this page. Okay, enter, or in mobile you can just scroll down, then it will automatically refresh. See, you can see here application has vanished. So now it is very easy. You can again go back and file the application from beginning. What you had to do? First, you had to log out. Again, you can click the menu by button here and click on log out here. Once you click on log out, again come back to the main home page automatically. Give your mobile number again and click on submit button. So after that, click give the OTP and enter. So now please remember, friends, second time when you log in, you don't need to fill applicant details. That means your details will be already saved. You can see here you have to only start from the deceased person details, the person who died, his details you have to start. You don't need to fill your own details. There will not be option to fill your own details. Continue from here, add the deceased person details and bank details and proceed. So in times anywhere in between you face the same issue and you are not going to complete, or you feel like discarding the previous application, this is the method you have to follow. Okay, friends, just go to menu, click on the application status and delete it. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, kindly give us a like. Also, please share and forward with your friends who is facing this problem. See you with another important video.